and there are rules how you can form how you can form adjective degree of adjective. So first let's see one example. He is an honest man. In this sentence, friends, we are simply telling about the quality of the man, that he is honest. So in such cases, when we are just telling about the somebody's or quality of something, then we just need to use positive degree. उसमें हम किसका यूज करते हैं? पॉजिटिव डिग्री. एंड व्हेन वी आर कंपेयरिंग समबडी और समवन, समबडी और समथिंग, देन वी यूज व्हिच डिग्री? कंपैरेटिव डिग्री. लाइक ही इज टॉलर देन यू. सो इन दिस सेंटेंस यू कैन क्लियरली सी दिस प्रोनाउन इज बीइंग कंपेयर्ड विद दिस प्रोनाउन. सो वी आर कंपेयरिंग द टू पीपल हियर. So therefore we have used which degree? Comparative degree. And when he is the best student in the class, best student in the class. So here we are comparing someone with the rest of the students, more than two things or two persons. So when we compare somebody or something with more than two person or two things, then which degree we use? We use superlative degree. So let me just quickly summarize. There are three degrees, and we only make the degrees of the adjective of quality. So first degree is positive degree, second one is comparative, and third one is superlative. And where these are used? First, positive degree, when we just simply tell about the quality of somebody, something, then we use positive degree. And when we draw a comparison or make a comparison between the two things or more than on two things or two person, then we use comparative degree. And when we just make comparison for more than two things or more than two people, then we use superlative degree. So these are the situations where these degrees are used. Now the rules are given, students, how you can form the degrees. Kaise degrees aap banate hain? Rules are also given related to this. So now we will see how to make how to form the degree of the different degrees. So if by first rule says that by adding er and est, er in the comparative and est in superlative, if you add these prefix in the comparative, er in the comparative and est in the superlative, we need to use in the positive degree, then it becomes the comparative and superlative. For example, great, it is also given in your book. So this is something positive degree, students. To make it comparative, what we need to do? We need to add er. So what would be the comparative? Greater. Similarly, to make it superlative, what we need to do? We need to add est. So what would be its superlative? Greatest. So in such way you can form comparative degree and a superlative degree from the positive degree. Another example, fast. What we need to add? ER. So what would be the comparative? Faster. Similarly, what we need to add in the superlative? EST. So what would be the superlative degree? Fastest. So such way you can form comparative degree and superlative degree from the positive degree. Is tarah se aap bana sakte hain. Let's find out the what the other rules say. Other rules say that if when an adjective ends with E, then what we need to do? We just need to R and ST, not ER. Like in the very first rule, students, we saw that we need to add ER to make comparative and EST to make a superlative. But when any adjective ends with E, for example, able. So in this word, you can clearly see able ends with the vowel e. So in such cases, you don't have to add e in the comparative and e again in the superlative. You just need to add r simply. So how we will make abler? Because e is already there, so we don't need to add e again. And similarly in superlative, we just need to add st, not est. So be clear about it. Don't be confused. Whenever you find a words ending with e, and when you have to make a comparative and superlative of it, then you don't have to add er into it. It means you can't double it. You just simply need to add r and st in the superlative. It's very simple. Now let's find out the third rule. What does it say? When an adjective ends with y preceded by consonant, then what we should, what we need to do in such case, students, we need to replace y with I, and then you need to add er or est. For example, busy. In this sentence, you can clearly see let's first understand what rule says. Y preceded by a consonant. Be careful that if a word ends with y, but you should also keep in mind that it should be preceded by consonant. It means the word which comes before it should be a consonant. So in this word, you can clearly see busy, s is consonant. So only in this situation, this rule applies, students. So what we need to do, how you can make comparative of this such words? So first you need to replace y with I. Let's make it bu. Now we will use I. We have replaced y with the I, and then what we need to add er. So this is how you can make the comparative, and this is how you can make the superlative. I think it should be easy one. Let's take another word from this rules. Dry, for example. Again, in this example, you can see dry. The word is ending with y, but before it, there is a consonant. Yahan pe kya hai? Consonant hai. So this rule apply in this for this situation. So what we will do? We will replace y with I, and what we will add er. So drier. And driest would be the superlative degree of dry, driest. So these are the easy rules. We have discussed the three rules, how to make a comparative degree and superlative degree from the positive degree in the of the different words. Now let's see the fourth rule, students. If you have any doubt, I will take your question. Don't worry about it. You can note it down right now. For now, let's see the fourth question. When an adjective ends with a consonant preceded by a vowel, so what we need to do, then you have to double the last consonant and then add er or est. Very simple rule, students. What rules is saying that when a word's adjective word ends with a consonant and before it a vowel has come, for example, big. See this example, big. Obviously, this word at it's ending with a consonant. G is a consonant, but before it is preceded by a vowel. Before it, a vowel has come. So in such situation, what you will do? You will have to double the last consonant. Isko pehle double karna padega, and then we have to add er in the comparative and est in superlative. So let's make it. Then we have to double the consonant, so it would be like this. And then we need to use bigger, and then biggest. But remember, when this rule applies, whenever you see a consonant preceded by a vowel in the word. Let's see one more example. Thin. Again, you can clearly see N is the consonant preceded by a vowel, I is a vowel. So in such situation, you have to double the consonant, then add er in the comparative and est in the superlative. Now let's move to the fifth rule. By adding more and more students, there are some adjective words which are formed or which are formed with the help of more than two syllables. What is syllable, students? Syllables, when you divide words into different parts, this is called syllable. For example, if I say thin, so if you just divide, thin, so it's just in a simple word you can pronounce it. But when you pronounce beautiful, for example, when you pronounce beautiful, then you can't pronounce in a single words, beautiful. So there are three division can be of the beautiful words. So whenever a words can be divided in more than two syllable, uske do se zyada tukde ho sakte hain, then in such cases, we don't have to add er or est. In such cases, when the word is big or something big word is big, you can say, or it is divided into more than three parts, in such cases you have to add more in the comparative and the most in the superlative before the adjective words. You can't add er or est, for example beautiful. So to make comparative and superlative of this word, you have to use more, because this word is divided into the more than two parts, or you have to pronounce it in the three parts, like beautiful, three syllables are there in this. So in such to make a comparative and superlative of such words, you have to use more and most, like words are given in the book useful. So how will you make? You don't have to use er or est, so we will use more useful. Similarly, to make superlative, we have to use most useful. So like this, you need to be aware of these words as well. Like words are given beautiful, difficult, intelligent, important. Such these words are divided into more than two syllable, students. That is the reason. If somebody asks you what is the reason, so these words are big words and are divided in more into the more than two syllable. What is the syllable? When these we just divide the words to pronounce it, and this is called syllable, students. And now let's move to the last rule, sixth rule. Some adjectives have irregular positive. It means they are a positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree can be quite different. Tino degree kya ho sakti hai? Puri different ho sakti hai. Like bad. So if you these adjective words, you better learn it, and either you be aware of it. Aap ya to yaad kar lijiye, inko aap pehchan lijiye. Like bad. So we can't say bad or baddest like this. You these are the adjective students which are irregular. So you have to learn their comparative degree and superlative degree, because if you don't learn, you might be confused. So what is the comparative degree of bad is worst, and superlative degree of it worst. So this you better, there is no rule, it's exception. You have to just how you can learn it, you have to just learn it. How you can just identify it, you have to learn it. And rest of the words, we have discussed the rules. I think it should be clear to you. Now, before we move further and before we start doing the exercise, if you exercise first, let's find out what we need to do. Rewrite the sentence using the correct form of adjective given in the brackets. Adjective is already given. You just need to identify the correct form of it and then rewrite the sentence. So let's see the first sentence. I'm also allowing you to speak so that we can have the we can discuss it. Who is the girl in the class? What would be the right adjective?
Who is the most intelligent girl in the class?
Yes, we have to use most, because in most something, this word can be divided into more than two syllables. So we have to use most, not est in the superlative. More intelligent. You can do it in the second sentence.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Which is the house in the street?
Oldest.
Oldest.
Older.
Sir, old.
Older.
Older.
One thing I'm telling you.
Oldest.
Oldest.
Just listen me again. Whenever you see article before the adjective, like in this sentence, you can see article has been used. The, you can clearly see the article is there. So whenever the article the is there, then only superlative degree is used. उस केस में कौन सा डिग्री यूज होता है?
Yes, sir.
Superlative degree.
Super.
So we use superlative degree. Oldest. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let's see the third sentence. Is this book than that one? Than is already there. So comparison is being
done. More useful.
Yes, right. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Mango. Yes, sir. And banana.
Yes, sir.
Sweeter.
Sweeter than banana.
Sweeter.
That's why you are so enthusiastically speaking. No problem. My sister is the of all children. Here the comparison.
Youngest.
Create panic in the group.
Sir, youngest.
Yes, I'm listening you all.
Sir, youngest.
Don't try to show that. I should listen to you. I'm listening to you all anyway.
Okay, sir.
Youngest. And next one, Birbal was than the other courtiers.
Wiser.
Why you will use wisest? Other is already there.
Sir, because there is not coming here.
Other word is there. When other word is there, then you have to use comparative degree. So we will use and then word is
there.
Then in such cases we have to use comparative degree.
Comparative degree.
Yes. Now let's talk about the seventh sentence. Prevention is. This is
better.
Someone saying
better.
Rajesh is a
now clever. You
clever boy.
Clever. Sir, kisi se compare nahi ho raha. Clever hi hoga.
Who is the boy in the class?
Most notorious.
Most notorious boy in the class.
Same sentence. Kashmir is one of the
most beautiful place in the world. Places.
Any problem?
Place.
No, sir.
B.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, आपने नाइन क्वेश्चन नोटोरियस यूज किया है. सर एक बार एक्सप्लेन कर देंगे.
Preeti, ask your question again.
Sir, why you use in nine question most notorious?
Because So what should we use? You first tell.
Article is used, sir.
No, just let her tell. Preeti, Preeti,
no, sir, why do you?
Because first, you know, notorious is big words. It's divided into more than two syllables. So we have to use most words because we need to use the superlative. So when the word is divided into more than two words, in such cases we use most for the superlative degree. And another thing is that who is the
iske pehle the
aaya comparing somebody with all the students, matlab we are comparing him with more than two person or two people. Clear? So in such cases we okay, use superlative degree. Look, your question can be typed. Either you are asking why we are using most, this could be the different question. And if you are asking why we are using superlative degree, this could be the different question. We are using superlative degree because comparison is is among more than two person or two things. And why we are using most? What is the reason behind it? Because this word is divided into more than two syllables.
More than two parts.
More than two parts, you can also say. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now.
Yes. Sir, notorious ke pehle the bhi aaya hai.
Yes, article. That is something for that. If the article is there, then it's quite clear that a superlative degree should be used.
Used.
Now let's see the exercise B. What we need to do? Tick the correct adjective in each sentence. The tortoise is one of the. Already the is there, so which one will you use?
Lowest.
Right
option.
Yes, sir.
Second.
Our classroom is clean.
Clean.
Because there is no comparison.
Clean.
Yes. In third sentence, is he of the two boys? Of the two boys.
Older.
Older.
Comparing
two people, two things. Comparative degree.
Older.
Yes.
Older.
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 Fourth sentence.
Now,
article the has come. So which degree should be used?
Happiest.
Superlative degree.
Happiest.
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 Happy.
Are you able to understand why we are
happy? Happy.
Yes,
are you able to understand?
Yes, understand.
Yes, sir.
Understand.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
My brother is an
most intelligent.
Intelligent.
Only intelligent.
Intelligent.
Only intelligent.
Intelligent. Who said
sir, intelligent?
Intelligent. Intelligent.
Yes, intelligent.
Intelligent.
Because, intelligent.
Because there is no confusion.
Yes, sir.
Intelligent. Good. Now, in the sixth sentence, Kavya is than her
richer than her richer than her
richer
than her richer than her
richer than her richer.
Yes, sir.
Seventh sentence. The bride is than the groom.
Younger.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Vinith is than I thought him to be.
Cleverer. Than I thought.
Cleverer. Okay, now in the ninth sentence. After the surgery, Jennifer is much
better.
Good.
Better.
Before the surgery and after the
better.
So two situations are compared. Better. Shakespeare is one of the
greatest.
This should be the right option. Clear? Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
One boy, Sivesh, was asking something. Sivesh. Can you hear me? If you can hear me, please ask a question. You are asking something. One boy was there. Yes. Ask your question.
किया था.
Don't you have any friend in the group? Ask them, no, they will send you. No, sir. How type of boy you are? You don't have any friend.
Sir, I'm a girl.
You are a girl. Beg your pardon. No problem. So, ask your friend, any friend. If they don't send you, then you ask me, WhatsApp me, I will send you, okay?
Sir, you will send anyone not want to send me.
No, no. If they are not, they will not send, yeah. I will send, no problem.
Yeah,
okay, WhatsApp me, I will send you. You can WhatsApp me, I will send you.
Yes.
Now, let's find out how much time we have. Exercise. We can complete one more exercise.
Yes, sir.
Yes. It's very easy one, students. You just need to write the positive degree.
Quick.
It's very easy.
Quick.
In the second word.
Small.
Sir, it's small. It's small.
Very small.
Very small.
Easy one. In third.
Good.
Yes, you all are very good.
Sir, sad.
Fifth. Most is only. Now you tell what would be the positive.
The many are
much.
Much.
Sixth.
Narrow.
Yes, right. Narrow. Seventh.
The clever.
Very good.
Clever.
Eight. The useful. Useful.
Useful.
Most useful.
Tall. Happy.
Sir, happy.
Happy.
You all be happy. Now it's time to end the class. Any problem to anyone?
No, sir.
Remaining exercises we will try to do tomorrow. Sir. There are some more rules. We will study them and then after that we will do the rest of the exercise. Okay,
sir. Okay.